Hello everyone. This is going to be a look at Model Context Protocol, which I'm sure you've all heard of by now. We're going to make our own client. We're going to do a client using Python with the SDK, the Python SDK. First thing we're going to do is we are going to consider why we want to make our own client. If you're on Linux, you'll see Mac, Windows, Windows ARM 64. So the first reason might be that you're a Linux user. You can check with Claude. Ask Claude why you might want to make your own. So the first reason, custom integration. You might want to integrate Claude with other systems or workflows in ways the desktop doesn't support. Privacy, so privacy and data, running your own server gives you more control how your data is handled, where it's stored. Deployment, you might need to deploy it where the desktop apps aren't practical. You might want to deploy it on a server. There's implications with doing that. You'll need to start handling sessions and so on in different ways. You might want to Dockerize it. Customization, you can modify request parameters. You could set up some sort of middleware. You can add custom processing, rate limiting, etc. Your organization might have requirements, compliance, network isolation requirements that say you can't use Claude Desktop, but you still want to use the MCP server. Batch processing, you might want to run large volumes of requests, etc. Learning, you might want to actually just learn how it works. So what I'm going to show here is how I developed using what is called a hybrid approach. We're going to skip to the code in a second, don't worry. So this is actually just using two functions or tools which we put inside the MCP server. The MCP server is Model Context Protocol server. So it's a protocol, which means that the server can work with any large language model provided you adhere to the protocol. So if you write it using the Python SDK or TypeScript, they actually offer TypeScript or Python. You can roll your own as well. You could write it in Rust, C, whatever. But for now, we'll stick with Python just to help to get familiar with it and understand it. So what I'm writing here, it's got two tools. One is just a calculator, a BMI calculator. The other is fetching weather from an API. Both of these are just going to be straight from your client straight to the MCP server. Okay, let's just quickly look at how we're going to build this or how it's built. So we've got the laptop, which is the computer that it's running on. Could be a laptop, could be a handheld, could be a Linux server even. So if the question, is about weather or BMI, the client will use the MCP server. Else, OpenAI. So that's how it's going to work. Okay, so what I did was I cloned my MCP client repo, which is in the link in the video description. So from here, we need to run uv run src client mcp client.py. You need to run that from the top of the project. And you can see it started processing request of type list tools request. And you can see server py. And as I found the available tools, calculate BMI and fetch weather. So let's ask it to, what is the weather in London? Using local function, get weather. Enter latitude, so what's that, about 51.0? longitude 1.0.1, and there we go. So it's used the API. We got the 200 response, and it passed in 51 from our entry into there, and it went off and used the API, and it got 10.9 degrees. The month is March 2025, so that temperature is very much what we would expect. So now let's ask it a question which won't be weather or body mass index related. So what is the highest building in the world? And then we can see using OpenAI. So using OpenAI, using local function. The largest, tallest building in the world is the Burj Khalifa in Dubai, United Arab Emirates. It stands at 828 meters. I kind of knew that already, so I don't really need to check that. I think that's a valid answer. And you can see it did the post to the OpenAI endpoint, API endpoint. So just to go back to my repo, add LM Interactive, add LM Hybrid. Hybrid is my most recent version, and that is the version where it just goes to the function straight away. So it's looking for keywords. Do you see how it's looking for BMI, body mass index? So if those keywords are in the prompt, it just goes straight to the function, the tool, the MCP server tool. When I say function, I mean MCP server tool. Apologize for that. So this really is getting my hands dirty with learning about how to command line or how to programmatically interact with large language models and MCP server client protocol. I've had help from Claude with this, by the way. So I've got Claude to help, but also I've started trying to write from scratch how to use async, because I think even some of the other YouTube channels you might see have fessed up to the fact that they're not experts at using async. Async is not something you would have always used in the past, but it's obviously highly important with ChatGPT and making requests. There's a lot of JSON decoding. Just remember that the choice, you'll always want to use the choice zero, so messages choice zero. Conversation history, just remember that you will need to append. As you append each of your responses, that then gets passed back with the next prompt. Also, remember async IO run and then run. So run here is the name of my function, def run. And that's using the std.io client, which comes from the Python SDK. And then there's some logic there, which is the detect and handle local function. So user input session. We're passing in the session each time. And that's a while loop, so that's always running, waiting for the next prompt. The best way to get familiar with this is to actually either do it yourself, start it yourself, ask Claude or ChatGPT to help you. But the key points are is understanding the flow of the program. So you want the while loop, while true, which is the loop which just constantly awaiting user input. Async, it's asynchronous, so you want it non-blocking because you don't want all these long delays while it's doing stuff. And MCP, so the important thing is to use MCP, which from MCP import client session to handle the sessions, std.io server parameters, you could use SSE types. That's just to enforce stricter typing. And then from MCP.io client.stdio import stdio client. So this is very important. And then with your OpenAI, you need to use async OpenAI. Server params, this, so I showed you in the previous video, the MCP inspector, and this is what you would pass in to the MCP inspector. You'd pass in the command. So I'll just quickly just show you that. So if we just cancel that, let me just go, so. MCP dev example server, and then the MCP inspector will give us the link, and then there we go with arguments with MCP run example server. Yeah, so it's completed those args for us. So if we connect, and we've got our tools, list of tools. We've got the calculate BMI there, which is your source. So if I put 1.77, 88, 1.77, run tool. It's called the tool. So that's the local tool. It's not doing any API stuff. If we do fetch weather, 51.1, and that's the one that's using the API, and then the response. Then you can see it's getting all that, but we're passing out the temperature, which was 10.9, I believe. Temperature's in there somewhere. Temperature is 14.2 now. Okay. Right. Prompts, resources. Those are the two other things. So if you've seen my other video, I've briefly discussed those, and I've altered the within the server. If you go into server, you see how that's called tool there. If you change that, you can change that to either one of these words, prompts or tool, and then it'll appear here, and then they behave differently. So you've got prompt, which is obviously a prompt, and then resource. A resource would typically be a file or something that would you, or a database, something running locally that is a resource. So thanks for watching. I'll put the link to the repo in the video description. Thumbs up. Don't worry about coding this from scratch. I used AI to help me. It's a lot of code. Just become familiar with async.io. Become familiar with appending the messages to your list. Become familiar with loading tools. Try and write your code so that as you add more tools, or as if the server has a different number of tools or tools with different names, it's still going to work. Don't just write your client to work with one server unless it's proprietary, it's in-house, and it's never going to be used by anybody else. So yeah, thanks for watching. Thumbs up, like, subscribe, and all that. Thanks. I'll be back soon.